Hi, I'm Guy Barker. I'm here to tell you about how Microsoft's Universal Windows Platform, or UWP, XAML framework enables developers to provide great, accessible experiences for all. Our UWP XAML framework will make many parts of your app accessible with little or even no work on your part. But there'll always be some additional action required by you as part of building the accessible experience that your customers deserve. For example, while a button, or a hyperlink button, can provide an accessible name to a screen reader by default, a combo box, list view, or text box might not. As such, your customers might not know the purpose of those controls when they encounter them. Well, XAML makes it easy to add an accessible name to the control. A great approach here is to have the accessible name set from a nearby label. By using a text block to label the control, then sighted customers will benefit too, and all your customers can efficiently learn of the purpose of the control as they navigate through your app. The UWP XAML framework often makes it extremely quick and easy to implement access keys, which can help to greatly improve the efficiency with which your customers can complete their tasks. Here we have a solitaire game built with the UWP XAML framework. The interactable elements along the top of the app are implemented using buttons and toggle buttons. And when the player presses their access keys, the associated button's click event handler, or toggle button's checked event handler, is called. So that's some really powerful functionality added to the app simply by adding something like access key equals N. Your customers will also be relying on you to respect their choices of timeouts for transient visuals. Instead of hard coding a timeout, with two lines of code, you can really help someone who finds dealing with transient UI a challenge by respecting their choice of timeout settings. If you build your own transient UI, rather than using some framework UI which respects your customer's choice of timeout by default, please remember to respect your customer's timeout setting. And it can also be straightforward to respect your customer's choice of other settings too, such as suppressing animations in your app. Thanks for watching. To learn more, visit the Accessibility for UWP Apps page provided in the Resources section of this video.